Hi everyone, I am Rajendra Survase and today we are going to discuss one experiment of sterile product subject, namely a formulation and evaluation of ascorbic acid injection IP 5 ml. So in this video, we will discuss the aim and objectives of this practical, requirement, then methodology, or the procedure, how to prepare ascorbic acid injection IP, then result and discussion observations table, a labeling guidelines, and some marketed formulations of ascorbic acid injection. See, aim and objectives of today's practical is to formulate and evaluate ascorbic acid injection 5 ml. So requirement: glassware, beaker, glass beaker 50 ml is required. Measuring cylinder, graduated measuring cylinder 10 ml. Then funnel, glass rod, stirrer, etc. Then list of chemicals: ascorbic acid LR, then sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydrosulfite, disodium editate, propylene glycol, and water for injections. Okay, so these excipients is a laboratory reagent grade, LR grade reagent is used for the preparation of this ascorbic acid injection. Then the equipment and instrument, a digital weighing balance is required, pH meter, digital pH meter, and stability chamber or environmental humidity chamber is required for the accelerated stability for this particular practical. So this is about the aim, objective, and the requirement. So see, the composition of ascorbic acid injection. These are the ingredient: ascorbic acid, sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydrosulfite, disodium editate, propylene glycol, water for injection as a solvent. Propylene glycol is to increase the solubility as well as the stability of this ascorbic acid injections. Disodium editate used as a chelating agent to form a complex. Sodium hydrosulfite, sodium bicarbonate, okay, and ascorbic acid. So these are the ingredient which is used in today's practical ascorbic acid injection. These are the quantity given in kg, kilogram, and this quantity is for 100 liter, okay, water for injection up to 100 liter. This is a quantity sufficient. So this 3% ORAGES quantity means what? The ascorbic acid to be taken extra 3%, because during the preparation, during the manufacturing of this ascorbic acid injection, the chances of the degradation, the chances of ascorbic acid degradation. So therefore, we have to take the extra 3% quantity of this. So therefore, this quantity became a plus a 3%. Okay, and this quantity for a 5 ml, all this quantity in a milligram. So ascorbic acid became a 525 milligram, then sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydrosulfide, disodium, propylene glycol, and water for injection up to a 5 ml. So this is about the formulations or the composition of ascorbic acid injection. Now see the monograph of ascorbic acid. This is about the structure of ascorbic acid. Molecular formula: C6H10O6, molecular weight 176.12 gram per mole. So category of this ascorbic acid is a vitamin and pharmaceutical aid as an antioxidant. A dosage, the average protective a dose of vitamin C for adult is 70 to 150 milligram daily, and in the presence of scurvy, a doses of 300 milligram to 1 gram a daily are recommended. So this is about the doses. See, the general description: ascorbic acid vitamin C is a water soluble vitamin, and it occur as a white or slightly yellow crystals or powder with a slight acidic taste. So this is about the overall a monograph of ascorbic acid. Now see the procedure, step wise procedure or the methodology for the preparation of this injections. So the first step, take a water for injection in a suitable egg container and weigh accurately all the ingredient, okay, on digital weighing balance. So weigh accurately. So let's see the methodology. The first step is a take water for injection in a suitable quantity, sufficient water for, because we are going to prepare this ascorbic acid 5 ml only, okay. So take a sufficient water for injection in a suitable container, small container to be used here. Then the bubble nitrogen through the bulk volume, okay. So nitrogen purging is required during the preparation of this ascorbic acid injection as well as the sealing process. So reason is to avoid the oxidation. So therefore there is need to bubble or purge the nitrogen gas throughout the bulk. So this is the second step. Then next step is a dissolve ascorbic acid slowly under constant stirring. Okay, dissolve ascorbic acid slowly under constant stirring. The next step is slowly add sodium bicarbonate in order to control the effervescence, and then dissolve sodium hydrosulfide in sufficient volume of water for injection in another vessel or beaker, and then add this sodium hydrosulfide solution into the bulk. Means prepared ascorbic acid bulk solution, we have to add sodium hydrosulfide solution. Next step is a dissolve sodium disodium ethidate in separately again in another vessel and then dissolve in the bulk. Okay, after that add and mix the propylene glycol. Okay, so this propylene glycol generally used to increase the solubility as well as the stability of product. So add and mix propylene glycol in the bulk solution. Then check the pH and adjust to 5.5 to a 6.5 with the sodium hydroxide or sodium bicarbonate. Okay, so this pH to be adjusted in between 5.5 to a 6.5. Then finally make up the volume with water for injection and fill in 5.3, the extra 0.3 ml to be filled in 5 ml amber colored ampoule. Okay, so this is the procedure or the methodology used to prepare the ascorbic acid injection in laboratory. Okay, so after preparation of ascorbic acid injection, we need to evaluate thoroughly this injection for its assay by using HPLC method. Can use the UV method, which is given in USP or IP or any titrometry method. Okay, then clarity test, pH, sterility test and leakage test. So these are the evaluation parameter: assay, clarity test, pH, sterility test, leakage test. And then we'll discuss later on stability study for the ascorbic acid injection. So the clarity test, the particulate matter is defined as unwanted insoluble matter other than gas bubble or air bubble which is present in the product or injection, and the permits limits of particulate matter as per Indian pharmacopoeias are as follows. You can see here the particle size in the micrometer range, and these are the maximum number of particle per ml. Suppose the particle size is a 10 micrometer, so the 50 particles is permissible per ml, okay, as per IP. 25 micrometer size particle, the 5, and 50 micrometer is a nil report is given. Okay, so this is about the permits limits of particulate matter as per Indian Pharmacopoeia. So the methods for monitoring a clarity. So there are many methods generally used to detect or monitor the number of particles which is present in a solution or injections. So visual method, then Coulter counter method, filtration method, and light a blockage method. But in the laboratory experiment, the visual method is widely used, and this is the apparatus, or you can say the clarity test apparatus, by using a dark background and light background for the detection of the particle. See, the ampoules are placed in a dark background, means this background, observe the light particle. Okay, means we can detect the light particle or white particle by using this dark background. Then a light background observe the dark particles for the detection of the dark or black particle by using this light background. Okay, so this is the visual method for the monitoring the clarity test. Now the pH determination by using a digital pH meter. So this is the diagram of digital pH meter. See, the pH meter must be calibrated before determining the pH of ascorbic acid injection. We need to calibrate the digital pH meter by using this standard buffer solution, a pH 4 or pH 7. Okay, so this is the very important step. The pH meter must be calibrated every day at pH 4 by using pH 4 buffer and pH 7 for accuracy results. Okay, then check the sample pH by dipping this electrode. Okay, so this electrode we are going to dip in a solution or injection, and then check the sample pH. Okay, and then place the electrode after determining the pH of ascorbic acid injection, then place the electrode in a distilled water after work is over. So this is the in brief or in short the standard operating procedure, how to calibrate or how to use the digital pH meter for the determining the pH of our ascorbic acid injection. So next evaluation parameter of ascorbic acid injection is a sterility testing by using a direct inoculation method or membrane filtration method. So direct inoculation method means the direct inoculation of the culture medium with a suitable quantity of the preparation to be examined, means our ascorbic acid injection is transferred directly into the appropriate culture medium, either a fluid thioglycolate medium or soybean casein digest medium at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius in incubator for not less than a 14 days. And membrane filtration method appropriate. This method is appropriate for filterable aqueous preparation, alcoholic and oily preparation. Okay. See, I have already prepared one video on a sterility test and pyrogen test, so you can get the more information about the sterility test and pyrogen test. Link is given in description box. So this is about the sterility testing. So next evaluation parameter is the leakage test or liquor test. So the liquor test is intended to detect the incompletely sealed ampoule so that they may be discarded from the batch. Usually detected by producing a negative pressure or a vacuum within the incompletely sealed ampoule, usually into a vacuum chamber, while those ampoule are submerged into a color a dye solution of 0.5 to a 1% methylene blue is solution. Vial and bottles are not subjected to such a liquor test because of a rubber's closure is not rigid. However, the bottles are often sealed while vacuum is pulled so that the bottle remains evacuated during its shelf life. okay. So by using 5.5 to 1% a methylene blue solution can conduct this test, okay. By producing a negative pressure in a chamber, so we can detect the incomplete a sealed ampoule, so that they may be discarded from the batch. This is about the result computation. After conducting the various evaluation tests for ascorbic acid injection, such as the assay, clarity test, stability test, leakage test, and a pH, we need to match these observations or the results with the standard values or reference standards, which is given in the official books in Indian Pharmacopoeia or USP. So here we are going to compare our results with the Indian Pharmacopoeia. Okay, so these are the predicted observations. Okay, assay 99.38%, so matches with the, suppose matches with the standard limits which is given in IP, so my conclusion is a complies as per IP standard. Okay, so the particulate matter found within the range as per IP. Okay, so this test as per IP, suppose more or maximum or more than the standard limits of the particulate matter was found in ascorbic acid, so my conclusion will be does not complies as per the clarity test, does not complies as per IP standard. Sterility test, no any turbidity in bumper tube, so it indicate that there is a no any growth of microorganism. Okay, means up to 14 days there is no any turbidity, no any precipitation in culture medium, so it indicate that no growth of, no presence of microorganism, means the sterility test is pass. Turbidity found, so it indicate presence of microorganism, means does not complies as per IP standard. Leakage test, no leakage or leakage, complies or does not complies as per IP. So this is about the result computation. Okay, we have to compare or match this observation, the test observation, with the reference standard or the standard given in official book. Accelerated stability testing of ascorbic acid injection at a 40 degrees Celsius temperature condition and 75% relative humidity condition. So this is you can see here the storage condition of 40 degrees Celsius temperature and 75% RH. Okay, and duration is a 1 month. Duration is a 1 month. So stability means what? See, the temperature, light, pressure, relative humidity, oxygen. So these are the different environmental factors may affect on the quality of product. Okay, quality of product means the after exposure of temperature or humidity, suppose the product does not change the any characteristics or any property of injection or any material, so that means it indicate that the product is stable. The product is stable. Now today's practical, suppose our ascorbic acid injection we are going to expose at higher temperature, means 40 degrees Celsius and higher relative humidity, 75% RH for 1 month and time interval 0. So 0 is the first time interval, that means the initial evaluation, after 15 days evaluation, and after 30 days evaluation, and then compare these three stages or three results. Okay, means 0 days reading of assays, 0 days the pH, clarity, sterility test, and leakage test. Again, these are the predicted values. Okay, and then after 15 days again withdraw the samples from this environmental chamber. So this is the environmental chamber, also called as the stability chamber or environmental humidity or stability chamber. Okay, so prepare three groups. First group is initial, means immediately after preparation evaluation is necessary. That means the 0 days or initial evaluations. So these are the 0 days evaluations. Then the second batch you can use after 15 days, means withdraw the sample, okay, after 15 days, and then again perform all these evaluation, means assay, pH, clarity, sterility and leakage test. Okay, then again after 15 days, means after 30 days samples, withdraw 30 days sample and again perform all these tests, assay, pH up to leakage, and then compare assay, okay, 0 days, 15 days and 30 days, compare pH, compare clarity test and compare sterility test, leakage test. Okay, suppose you found there is no any huge change, major differences in 0 days, 15 days and 30 days. Okay, so we can confirm the ascorbic acid injection is stable at 40 degrees Celsius, 75% RH up to at least 1 month, up to a 30 days. So this is what the stability, accelerated stability study. Okay, so this is about the labeling guidelines of this injection. You can write here, the label should be appropriate, neat and clean on the ampoule. Small size label and neat and clean, appropriate label should be there. Okay, so ascorbic acid injection IP 5 ml, can mention here, for intramuscular and intravenous use. Okay, each ml contains ascorbic acid 100 milligram, water for injection quantity sufficient. Store in a cool and dark place. Doses as directed by the physicians, manufactured by your name, okay, name of a student you can mention here. Okay, this is about the manufacturing license number, you can write here XYZ, batch number, your batch ABC, whatever, manufacturing date, okay, expiry date, MRP. okay, do not use if found particle or suspended matter. Okay, such a type of a direction or instruction to be mentioned here in a red ink. Okay, manufactured at, you can mention here your name of the college. So this is about the labeling guidelines, how to prepare the label of ascorbic acid injections on ampoule. These are the some marketed preparations of ascorbic acid injection IP. See this summary and conclusion. Ascorbic acid injection IP 5 ml was formulated and evaluated successfully. And conclusion of this practical, the ascorbic acid injection was evaluated for its assay, pH, clarity test, sterility test, leakage test, and the results matches or does not matches, whatever your result will be there. Okay, with IP standard, hence this injection has a good quality and the stability. So this is about the summary and conclusion of this practical. Thank you very much for watching this video.